Hey, we're Cosmo's Midnight. I'm Cosmo.
And I'm Pat. And we are going to be breaking down
Idaho. Yep.
Wow, we synced it.
Nice.
For this song, we're just in our bedroom studio. Our friend Joey, he's also known as Young Franco, was over and we were just flicking through demos that we had. And he just sent me this project which had a cool drum beat in it. And the moment I heard that beat, I was just like, I have the entire song in my head. I know what to do.
Yeah, we wrote this track in about a week. It was one of the quickest songs we wrote on the album. Often our albums have these two parts of it where we write some songs in a day or two that we, you know, finish over a month or so, or ones that we just write for a whole year almost. I mean,
yeah.
But you know it's in there and you gotta pull it out.
Yeah, like, Idaho is about, it's like the grass is greener syndrome encapsulated in the song.
Mm.
And Idaho was like the lyric because I was singing, should I go, I don't know. And then I just changed it to Idaho because I was trying to think of a place. And then I was like, Idaho is this like wilderness. It's really cold and icy, complete opposite to Australia, which is beachy and summery. Because sometimes going to the other place, you realize you already had a good. So you just need to
go there and find out for yourself.
It's just a funky idea about being indecisive.
Mm. So this track, like, it sounded kind of fun and clumsy, but like we slowly built it into like sounding a lot more built
up. This is another one where the middle eight was the first part of the song.
Mm. We actually sent it to a few vocalists for ideas, but then we ended up coming up with the idea ourselves, and we were like, just actually, don't worry about coming up with an idea. We're actually really happy with our own.
I think the first idea in the song was like this middle eight, which was been feeling good because I'm young and not old, and it's just like youthful optimism. That middle eight is sort of the realization of like you don't need to sweat about where you're going because you know you're young and can fuck up and figure it out.
I'd say my favorite part of the track is there's like a fun solo that I do in this track, and it happens like three or four times throughout. Yeah, and I hope I can do that live. I don't know, there's just so many things in this track, but I feel like Stephen coming on and laying some vocals down really pulled this together. So.
Yeah, he's a super talented vocalist, and he always does harmonies that I would never expect.
Like interesting
and
choices.
It just adds an extra element that, I just can't do on my own.
The inspirations for tracks are like, it's like a kind of all your favourite things mesh together and then put your own lens.
Yeah, we're just like really big fans of music, so I guess our sound is just a huge blend
amalgamation.
Tons of music.
But then we like kind of filter it through our songwriting style and it becomes its own thing through that process.
Basically there was this vinyl that is like a compilation record of disco and funk.
Mm.
And that basically encapsulates a lot of our sound. It's got like the Bee Gees, like
Chaka Khan,
Casey and the Sunshine Band,
Kool and the Gang. And that was kind of like a big part of this record was finding similarities between our music and stuff that, you know, from 30 to 40 years ago, and appreciating the circle of music and how you kind of form them into a new idea.
I can think of an inspiration for that song. It was Jamie XX's Loud Places with Romy.
Really?
How that song is based on a sample that I can't remember, but in the chorus it has like this building, like just eighth note tom, and I was like, I want to do that in this song. Also, the bass line on this one was a lot more simplified than our usual stuff. Mm. Because I just want everything to follow this groove.
The power was actually like really like directive.
I like knew exactly what I wanted.
Stop doing like what you normally do. Just do this simple one and don't overthink it.
And the chords are like ultra simple. Usually we do like these really complex big chords, but I was playing around with just doing like two notes to three notes. Simple triads, keeping everything really simple and basic.
Yeah, so that was Idaho. Hope you learned something new about the track and how we write. And hope you enjoyed it.
Could not be at that point.